Welcome back. Today we'll talk about populating a combo box with unique items from a worksheet. So here we have data with the items, quantity purchased, quantity sold, and the quantity available. Every time we enter data here into the items, surely we will not purchase every day, but we will sell something every day and we will purchase certain items on the days whenever the reorder value becomes applicable. Okay. So sometimes also, you know, the data entry operator may not enter something. He may enter something on the next line here. So how can we get all this data into a combo box, and all the data that we get into the combo box should be unique? That means no duplicates. For example, we have added here hard disk drive, so we purchased some quantity, we sold something. On some other day, we sold again some hard disk drives. Now we don't want this to be repeated in our combo box. So let's see how we can do this, and you will also see some of the benefits of creating a combo box and then displaying some interesting information. Alright, so let's go to the developer tab, Visual Basic, insert, we'll create a user form, and in this user form we will place a combo box control. So we will click and drag, and then we will have a command button that will close our form when we are done with our work. So we will give this the caption here on the left hand side in the properties. We'll give it the caption exit. So let's say we have created a form like this. Now what we want to do is, when we run the form, for example, if I run this form, at present you will not see anything because we haven't done anything. Our aim would be to get these item names into our combo box, but only the unique items. Okay, close it from here. We will double click this. This requires only one line of code, unload me. So we'll run this again, and if you click on this, it will unload the form. Now when we open this form, we want the items to come here, so we are going to write the code for that. So we will double click on the user form, and we are brought to this code area. Now we don't want this on click, but we want the combo box to be populated when we start the user form or open the user form. So instead of the click procedure here, we will take the initialize procedure. Okay, this we can delete. Now in the initialization process, we will define variables. So dim, my collection, as collection. I have described this variable in detail in another video. I'll give a link to that. You can have a look and see what this collection does. Collection is, as the word says, collection. It's like an array. However, it is different from the array that you don't need to have similar items in the collection. Okay, then we will define cell as range. Now we will use an error handling procedure, and you will understand as I write the code why we use the error handling right here. So on error, resume next. That means if there is an error, just continue with the code. So we will set my collection assign it the value new collection. So we are instantiating a collection. Okay. Now with combo box 1, we have created one combo box. So with combo box 1, we will do certain things. First thing we'll do is clear whatever is inside it. Alright, that's the clear method. Then we will loop through our worksheet and get the item names into our combo box. So we will say for each cell in range, and we are starting with range A2 because our range A1 has a header, and we will go through the whole column A and cells rows dot count comma 1, then we will go up and excel up dot row. Now what does this line of code do? I forgot the parenthesis or bracket. Now what does this line of code do? It actually loops from cell A2 right up to the last row that has been used in your worksheet. Now we will say if len cell not equal to 0, then why not equal to 0? Because the operator would have left some rows blank, and we don't want those blanks to come here. Okay, so if some error has been observed or noted during the program, we will clear that error.clear. So my collection dot add. Now this is what my collection does. It will add a cell value, and the key that it takes will be the cell value itself. So if you have a duplicate, we would get an error. That is why we are using the error handling. So we are clearing the error, and if now there is no duplicate, that means if error.number assign the value 0, then we will add the item. Otherwise, we will not add that cell value. Now, this is the way to get unique values into your combo box, right? And if an error happens, it just goes on. The program doesn't stop. And if, because we started with an if, then we will end with, okay, because we started with combo box 1, and of course then we have right at the bottom and sub. Okay, now the proof of the pudding lies in its eating. So if this line of code or this complete code is perfect, then alone the user form will be populated with unique items. So in the unique items, we use this idea here. That means the key value will go into the collection, and from the collection it will go to the combo box if and only if it is a new item. Okay, this is what the error number here defines. Alright, that value is added to the combo box only if it is new or unique. Best thing is first, let's run this. Okay, so I'll click on the run button. And it says, and with, without with. Now, here everything is fine. What I forgot here is to complete the loop by saying next cell, because I started with for each cell and I forgot to write next cell. Okay, so we'll reset this, run it, and there you see if I click on this, you see all the values here and none of them is repeated. Okay, so if I click on exit now, I will unload the user form. That means it will be cleared away from the memory. Now, if you notice here also, nothing is being displayed. So if I wish to display the first item in the combo box, I'll have to write a single line of code. So I'll do that. So I'll go back to the user form here. And after end with, I will write here combo box to display the first item. Okay, so list index, this one, press the tab key and assign the value 0, because the index starts with 0. We'll run this again and see this in action. So there you see the first item as I enter the data here. Okay, so not in alphabetical order, but as I enter the data here. Okay, so I'm going to exit now. I'll go to the sheet. I'll minimize this first. So I'll go to the sheet and enter some data here. Okay, so let me enter something like just RAM. Okay, not 4 GB, just RAM. And let's say I purchased 12 and I sold nothing, and then I enter here Intel i5. So I sold, let's say, 4. Okay, now you see if I go back to my form, you will see this would be entered but this would be ignored. So Visual Basic, let's run this, and if I click on this, you see RAM has been added, and this is added exactly the way I did, the way I worked in the sheet. So it has taken it from there. i5 CPU already exists, so it is not added. No duplicates are added. Alright, now we'll do something more interesting. Okay, let's go back to our worksheet. So you see, if you wanted to find the quantity available, you would use the SUMIF formula, because we don't want to calculate just this, but we want to see here if something else has been sold or purchased, and then we should know what is the quantity available. So we will normally use is equal to SUMIF in a worksheet, and range is this range. Criteria is, let's say, this one, that is the hard disk drive, and the range to be summed is this one. Okay, this is the quantity that we have purchased. Now, if we minus that from the SUMIF quantity that we sold, we do the same thing. We take this as our range, comma, we take this as our criteria range, comma, and we take this as our sum range now, the quantity sold. All right, parenthesis close and press enter. Now you see you get exactly what you want, but you cannot do an autofill here for obvious reasons. You can check this out. So if I click on hard disk drive, I purchased 10 on some date, I sold 2 here, then I sold 3 here, so that is 5. So my quantity available is 10 minus 5, isn't it? So I get 5. I can do the same thing with, for example, Intel i5 CPU. Okay, so we'll go here and write SUMIF, parenthesis open, so our range is this one, comma, we will take the first entry here, comma, and this is what we purchased, the total, parenthesis closed, then minus sum if, again we have our range here, comma, and we have our criteria. We select the Intel i5 CPU item, comma, and then we select the quantity sold. So if we close the bracket and press enter, we get here 1, and let us see. So we have 10, we have purchased 10, we sold 3, then here we sold 2, so 3 and 2, 5, and Intel i5 we sold 4 here, so we sold totally 9, we purchased 10, and we got 1 here. Okay, now this is quite tedious, isn't it, if you do it for each item. Now you can do the same thing on the user form. So let's go back to Visual Basic and let's add a label here. Okay, so we will add a label here. So that's our label 1. We'll add another label. Label 2. Now what do we want to do here? Whenever I select an item, I want the total quantity available to actually come here. I should get a label saying total quantity available and then the real quantity. Okay, so I'm going to now code this because that will happen when something in the combo box changes. So I'm going to select this, double click on this, so you see combo box 1 changed. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to say label 1 dot caption, and I'm going to give it a simple caption, and I will say total and combo box 1 value, combo box 1 dot value, and we'll just say available. Now what will this do? It will tell you in a line total, the name of the item that we select, and then of course write the text available, and in the second label we will display the quantity. So label 2 dot caption and we will use the worksheet function. So worksheet function dot sum if, you see we are using the SUMIF function like we did in our worksheet. We will take the range as columns 1 because columns 1 is the column A. Alright. Then our criteria range will be combo box 1 dot value. Okay, and the sum that we are going to find out, the quantity, that is in columns 3. Okay, columns 2, because that is what we purchased. Now from that we will minus again, just like we did on the worksheet. So worksheet function dot sum if and here we'll have the columns 1, that is the item name, that is our range, and then again we will take the combo box 1 dot value, that will be our criteria. Okay, and the value that we are going to look for now is the value sold, which is in columns 3. Okay, and parenthesis closed. Press enter. Now you see, oops, there's a mistake here. Let me just check where that mistake is. So worksheet function dot sumif columns 1 combo box 1. I think I forgot a bracket here. Okay, so I'll enter that and let's see. Because I'm opening a bracket here, I need to close it at the end also. Okay, so it's done. Now let's have a look at our object. So we'll keep this labels here, okay, for the time being. Alright, and we'll run this now. So when we run this, you see, it immediately gives us this value because we have selected hard disk drive. So if you select now, let's say i5 CPU, you get 1 and you know this is perfect. That's what we found out here also. You see that? 1 and 5. So if you click here and let's say do this one, so you get the result. Now of course you can format this so that this, let's exit. So you can format this to display it in a different way. For example, it could be bold. So I've gone to font, click on these ellipses. Make it bold. Okay. And we click here. We can do the same thing here. We can make it bold. And of course, if you wanted, you could change the color also. Alright, so we run this again. And there you see hard disk drive 5. And you can see whatever we calculated is right there. 5. Okay. So monitors, we purchased 10, sold 4, we have 6. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.